Yes, good evening, my dear students. Welcome to online classes. Today, one of the topic from solutions, that is ideal and non-ideal solutions. We have finished before vapor pattern of the liquid and vapor pattern of the solid sheet liquid. And with Raoul sir. Today, what are the ideal solutions and what are non-ideal solutions? Now coming to ideal solutions. So ideal solutions, so the solutions which obey the Raoul's law, those are called ideal solutions. The solutions which obey the Raoul's law is called ideal solutions. For example, the solutions which contain two components, consider solutions which contain two components. Here A and B are two components in a solution. Now A being is called what? Two components means is the solution. The force of attraction of solution, A is one component, B is another component. Here A is considered a solvent. Here B is considered solute. Solute plus solvent is called what? Solution. Now AB is one solution. The force of attraction of solution is equal to the solvent and solute. In ideal solution, the force of attraction solution is equal to solvent and solute. When two components are mixing, here there is no enthalpy changes. Means here what? Gain of enthalpy means there is no gain of enthalpy, loss of enthalpy. So that is there is no change in enthalpy. There is no change in enthalpy. That is why when mixing of two solutions, that is called delta mix. Enthalpy change means we have to denote with delta. Here what we change is enthalpy, now it is taken as H is equal to 0, means what? There is no enthalpy changes. During the formation of ideal solution, there is no enthalpy changes, there is no change in enthalpy. Here when mixing of two solutions, volume also no change, means delta mixing of volume is equal to 0. Delta mixing of volume also 0 for ideal solution. So here how to express ideal graph equation? Now if you take the graph, draw in between mole fraction and vapor pressure. Now ideal solution, this shows the means here x1 is equal to consider 1, here x2 is considered 0. Here x1 is considered 0, x1 is considered 1. Here x1 is 0, now it is component 1. This shows the straight line. But less vapor pressure. Now we have to draw it like this.
this is component 1. Now here x1 value is 1, that is why here this is considered vapor pressure of the P1 naught. This component 1, that is vapor pressure is that is P1 naught. Here x1 is 1, that is why this is considered component 2. Vapor pressure value is greater than first component. So here this is component 2. Here consider P2 naught. According to Dalton's law of vapor pressure, sum of the partial pressure of the two components. Now it is combined with two lines. Now P total is equal to P1 plus P2. P1 plus P2. So partial pressure first component, partial pressure second component. This is ideal gas. For ideal gas, this is the graph. This is the graph for ideal gas. So what are the examples? So here generally solutions, there is no true ideal gas solutions. But some solution behave like a ideal solution. Here some solutions behave like ideal solution, but there is no true ideal solution. So some examples are, if you take N hexane plus N heptane and chlorobenzene plus bromobenzene. And benzene plus toluene. These are the example for ideal solutions. These are behave like a ideal solution, but not true solutions. Ideal solutions. This is about ideal solution. Means the ideal solution means the solutions which obey the Raoult's law. Those are called ideal solutions. Here A and B are two components in a solution. Means AB is a, now it is a what? Solution. Now the solution attractive force is equal to the AA and BB. So what are the characters for ideal solution? For ideal solution, there is no change in enthalpy. Means heat is not absorbed, not loose. Heat is not absorbed, not loose. That is why delta mixing H is equal to 0. And volume of these two components also is equal to 0. Now this is the graphical representation for ideal solution. These are the examples. Next one, what is the non-ideal solutions? Non-ideal solutions means the solutions which does not obey the Raoult's law. So non-ideal solutions. Ideal solutions. So for non-ideal solutions, how to define the solutions which does not obey the Raoult's law? The solutions which does not obey the Raoult's law. Is called non-ideal solutions. For non-ideal solutions, AB intramolecular force, here AB solution intramolecular force is not equal to the solvent solvent and solutor solute, that is BB. So not equal means what? Either greater than or less than. Greater than or less than. So for non-ideal solutions, enthalpy mixing is not equal to zero, means delta H, delta mixing H is not equal to zero. And volume also, delta mixing of volume is not equal to zero. Not equal to zero. So examples are non-ideal solutions. So water plus HCl. Next one, choline plus benzene. That is water plus HCl, water plus H2SO4, water plus H2SO4, ethyl alcohol and water, water plus ethyl alcohol. All these are examples for non-ideal solutions. So here non-ideal solutions are again classified into two types. One is non-ideal solution with positive deviation, non-ideal solution with positive deviation, and second one is non-ideal solution with negative deviation. This is about ideal and non-ideal solutions. Now it is easy concept. If you know ideal solution, you can easily understand that is non-ideal solution. For ideal solution, R are equal to zero. Raw characters means enthalpy and volume, intramolecular force are four. Solution is equal to solute and solvent. But non-ideal solutions, intramolecular force of solution is not equal to solvent and solute, but your characteristics of non-ideal solution, change in enthalpy is not equal to zero, change in volume is, mixing of volume is not equal to zero. These are the examples of non-ideal solutions. So here not equal to zero means now either greater than or less than. So that is why here non-ideal solutions are classified two types, that is non-ideal solution with positive deviation, non-ideal solution with negative deviation. Now what are the positive deviation of Raoult's law? What is negative deviation of Raoult's law? So means positive deviation of deviation, negative deviation. What is? So see here, what? Now coming to positive deviation and negative deviation. Now first one is positive deviation of Raoult's law. Means positive deviation, non-ideal solution, positive deviation. So here positive deviation means the solution vapor pressure is greater than Raoult's law predicted values. The solution's vapor pressure is greater than predicted by Raoult's law. The solution vapor pressure means any one solution whose solution vapor pressure values are greater than predicted by Raoult's law, those are called positive deviation, in which molecular interforce means solution of intramolecular force, AB is a intramolecular force, is weaker than that is solvent and solute. For example, if you take this is a container, is containing A and B molecule, A and B molecule. Now, the solution molecular force AB, solution molecular force is less than AA and BB. This force is less than AA and BB means, now these are weakly bonded with the solution now. Now these are easily escaped from surface. So now easily get evaporated. Means, so AB intramolecular force is less than or weaker than AA and BB. So molecules can escape easily. So BB weaker than AA and BB. So molecule means your components. What happens? This is easily escape from surface of the liquid. But here the component change in enthalpy, that is delta mixing H is greater than 0. Means what? It has some values 1, 2, 3 something, because we are weak under weaker force now in between solution and solute and solvent. So is greater than 1 means what? So due to presence of weaker. Okay, that is why it has greater than values, greater than 0 values. So here delta mixing of enthalpy is greater than 0 and delta mixing volume is also greater than 0. For example, if you take graph in between vapor pressure and mole fraction, how they are deviated from Raoult's law. Means Raoult's law means what here? The ideal solution which behave like a, that is obey the Raoult's law means how the positive deviation of solutions related to ideal solution. For ideal solution, what is here? X1 is equal to 1, X2 is equal to 0. This is mole fraction. X-axis is mole fraction. Right. Here Y-axis is a vapor pressure. Here X1 is equal to 0, X2 is equal to 1. For ideal solution, this is the graph. So this is P2 naught. This is component 1. This is component 1. Here P1 naught. Here P2 naught. Now this is the line combined with P1 plus P2. Now P total, PT is equal to P1 plus P2. This is ideal gas. For ideal solution, this is the graph. Positive deviation means what? The solution whose vapor pressure is greater than predicted by Raoult's law. So, for component 1, the vapor pressure of the solutions greater than means we show the like this. Greater than. This is the ideal gas vapor pressure values. The solution whose vapor pressure is greater than, this is for component 1. For component 2, this is values. This is 2. The line is greater than dotted lines now. These straight lines with thick lines are, that is positive deviation vapor pressure. And dotted lines are ideal gas. Now total pressure also shows the lines. Right. Now it is called, so you can denote it with the dotted lines. Now thick lines are there, no? These are positive deviation. These are the ideal solutions, Raoult's law values. This is the graph indication for positive deviation. So in positive deviation, the Weber-Fizer values are always greater than, means above the curve of ideal solutions. For negative deviation means, so what are the solutions to show the positive deviation? Positive deviation, that is ethanol plus water. Examples: ethanol plus water, ethanol plus acetone, ethanol plus acetone. Acetone. Next one is acetone plus carbon disulfide. Acetone plus carbon disulfide. All these are example for positive deviation of Raoult's law. Positive deviation of Raoult's law. What are negative deviation? So negative deviation. So what is negative deviation? So negative deviation means opposite to positive deviation. So here what the vapor pressure of the solution, whose vapor pressure of solution is lesser than the predicted by Raoult's law. The solutions vapor pressure is lesser than predicted by what? Raoult's law values. Raoult's law. Predicted by Raoult's law. So here the force of attraction in between solution and solvent. Here AB intermolecular force is stronger than AA and BB. So here change in enthalpy delta H means delta mixing H is lesser than 0. Here delta mixing volume is less than 0. For this one graphical representation, this is P2 naught, this is P1 naught. Here x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 0. Here x1 is equal to 0, x2 is equal to 1. Here mole fraction x, here vapor pressure. Now this is total pressure. So that is Pt is equal to P1 plus Pt. So the vapor pressure of the solutions is lesser than predicted by means what? So the solution vapor plus below the ideal solutions. This is vapor pressure of other solutions. Now this is ideal solutions. This is indication for negative graph, negative deviation. So the curve of vapor pressure value, whose values are lesser than ideal solution values. Now it is representation of negative deviation. What are the examples? Water plus HCl. Water plus H2SO4 plus water. And water plus HNO3. Water plus HNO3. And phenol plus aniline. phenol plus aniline, acetone plus aniline. These are the example for positive deviation of Lavoisier. So this is non-ideal solutions. Non-ideal solutions values are classified two types. That is positive deviation of Lavoisier, negative deviation of Lavoisier. Means for negative deviations, non-ideal solutions are not equal to zero. Means here not equal to zero means what? Either is greater than or less than. So that is why based on that, the solutions are non-ideal solutions are classified two types. That is positive deviation and negative deviation. In positive deviation, the Weber-Pedraza solution is greater than predicted by Raoult's law. So that one you have to express in terms of graph. Greater than means Weber-Pedraza other solutions are above the ideal solutions. For non-ideal solutions, below the ideal solutions. In positive deviation, the solution attract force is weaker than solvent-solvent and solute-solute. So that is why here delta mixing enthalpy is greater than zero and volume also greater than zero. These are the examples. And negative, what happened? The AB solution molecular force is stronger than solvent-solvent and solute-solute. Here mixing of enthalpy is less than zero. Here mixing of volume is less than zero. Examples are all these. So this is positive deviation and negative deviation, right? So this is ideal and non-ideal solutions. Tomorrow I have to explain what are the azeotropes, what are the examples, means what type of azeotropes. Next one is Colgate properties. What are the properties of solutions? That is Colgate property. Thank you.